Uganda has been exporting minerals such as gold, tin, tantalum and tungsten to Europe, China and the US. It is estimated that the country earns more than $140 million every year from minerals, but this can grow fivefold if the bureaucracy, secrecy and corruption reported in the minerals sector can be checked. The minerals found in Uganda that can be exploited commercially include copper, cobalt, beryl, chromite, gold, iron, lead, lithium, tantalite, tin, tungsten, silver, zinc, limestone, phosphates, glass sand and other rare metals. Surveys also show that Uganda has about 52,000 square kilometers of uranium prospects. Going by reports from the Auditor General's office, government has over the years invested in supporting the mining sector to grow through the purchase of sophisticated equipment and materials needed in enabling extraction of quality minerals. For example, in the financial year 2014-2015, the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development purchased geophysical equipment worth 1.5 billion shillings, equivalent to $430,000. The Auditor General's report further stated that in 2012, the Directorate of Geological Survey and Mines acquired an X-ray fluorescence machine and an atomic absorption spectrophotometer at a combined cost of approximately 465 million shillings, equivalent to $133,000. However, this equipment was found non-operational less than 3 years later. This implies that Uganda could have lost 480 billion shillings just from the mismanagement of such expensive facilities. On the other hand, the move to lift the ban on the exportation of unprocessed minerals by both local and international players could have discouraged investors who are planning to start processing the minerals locally. This could have created job opportunities for many Ugandans. In 2011, President Museveni had directed the concerned ministry to stop miners from selling minerals in raw form, arguing that this denied the country income and employment. But towards the end of last year, he rescinded the decision. The Auditor General's report further revealed that the directorate concerned lost 500 million shillings in uncollected mineral taxes and fees. According to the report, out of the 8.9 billion shillings the ministry had assessed as mineral taxes or fees for the year, only 8.4 billion was collected. The report added that during their field inspection, the Attorney General's office noticed that a mining company had not declared 3.5 million tons of tin which it had mined, contrary to the Mining Act. Such undeclared production denies government its much-needed revenue. All these revelations show that Uganda can earn substantially from its minerals if the sector is properly managed. The sector can fetch over $700 million every year with the current equipment put to good use. This is equivalent to 2.3 trillion shillings. Reggie Manuel, reporting for Urban Television.